Zenyatta is the ultimate DPS hero in disguise. He is very squishy, but deals insane amounts of damage to the point you will forget that you were even playing a support. When I first started playing Overwatch, I was often forced into picking the support role, and that's where I ended up falling in love with this hero. In this video, I'll give my top 5 tips to help you climb ranked as Zenyatta. Tip number 1. LOS, or line of sight, is something you always need to keep in mind. Zenyatta's orbs have no falloff damage and really wreak havoc on an enemy team from any distance. An important step you can do to help improve your weapon accuracy is to position yourself in places where you can hit your enemies in a straight line. This includes narrow spaces where people will naturally tunnel to. You need to find and remember these locations on different maps. Knowing where they are allows you to position yourself so that the enemy has to get hit by your volley of orbs if they want to go anywhere. Staying in line of sight consistently will overall increase the amount of kills you get and help you build ult charge faster. Tip number 2. Don't be afraid to run away. Have you ever been in a situation where an enemy Reinhardt is chasing you down, and as you try to escape, you walk backwards while shooting at him, only to fail because he just seems slightly faster and able to catch up? It's not that the enemy is faster, it's that you are moving slower. Whenever you walk backwards as Zenyatta, your speed is reduced. Although it could be tempting to try and shoot orbs as you are moving backwards, in some situations the better play could be to just turn around and hightail it out of there. Retreat around a corner where you can get out of LOS, recover some of your blue shields naturally, then charge up one of your right clicks and hit the pursuer with it when he isn't expecting it. You could always look for reinforcements to help take care of them as well. Tip number 3. Constant game awareness and checking your surroundings. Since you are this powerful but easy to break glass cannon type character, you will be the focus of many dives and flanks. Enemy tracers will always travel long distances out of sight just to jump on you from the flank in order to get an easy pick. Constantly be aware of where the enemy is and what possible locations they would take in order to try and dive you. Stay away from these locations and always check them. Try to maintain a constant right-click volley prepared so that whenever they try to attack you, you will be able to defend yourself. Staying near a tank, your other healer, or natural cover will also help keep you safe. Tip number 4. Always apply your Discord to enemy flankers so you can maintain information about where they are located and where they are going. Your Discord will not remain on them forever, but you will be able to get a general sense of where they are and where they are heading. Use this information to get the jump on them with a volley, or you can communicate to your team so you can go together. If those options don't seem good, then just leave the area and go to somewhere the enemy flanker isn't heading towards. Moving towards a health pack location can also help you get the advantage if it comes down to that 1v1. Tip number 5. Don't be afraid to use your ultimate to save yourself from death. Using Tranquility is best when you can save your team from powerful ultimates like Genji's Dragonblade or Hanzo's Dragonstrike. However, if you are being dove on and focused heavily, it's better to use your ultimate to save yourself rather than just dying for free. Once they kill you, then the enemy will likely just use their ult immediately just to clean up the rest of your team since they no longer have to worry about your tranquility saving anybody. It is much more advantageous to be alive to help your team kill the Genji during his Dragon Blade by assisting with attacks and Discord Orb, rather than just being dead for free with the Dragon Blade killing your team anyways. That's all I have for now, guys. Let me know what you guys think. If there's any tips out there you have for Zenyatta, let me know about them in the comments. Until then, I'll see you guys next time.